I'm happy to be here to join with you in this first Herndon Lights Up the Holidays event of the new millennium.
I want to thank the Herndon Council of the Arts again for their leadership in helping to put this together. Let's light up the holidays. If we could all raise this and then go inside for the next part of our program.
It's a wonderful event, and we have a couple of thousand people that come here for it, and I love every part of it.
I'm Vicki Dorman. I'm Vice President for the Council for the Arts of Herndon. And just we're running this event for the 15th year, and we're really happy that this year we're donating some of the proceeds of this to the Musicians Village in New Orleans. We're an arts organization and we work in Herndon, but those people were hurt really bad. As an arts group, we're going to help another arts group.
The food is excellent. It's just a great event to bring the community together, and I think if you're listening, come on now.
But it's for such a good cause. I mean, this money goes to support the arts in the greater Herndon area and the artists, and they just add so much to the quality of life here in town.
50 bucks for the football. We got a bid for 50 bucks. Don't forget Father's Day right around the corner. Can I get 60 bucks? We got 60. We're going to 70.
I want to thank the foundation for hosting us this evening in Art Space in Herndon. We're all working together to find a permanent solution to the need in our community for an art center in our downtown. You know, ArtSpace has just been so spectacularly successful in running programs and bringing people out and showing, I think, the entire community that Herndon really is an arts community. It's really one part of the heart and soul of our town. And it's one of the reasons so many of us love it so much.
It woke up the earth sleeping underneath his bed. And every sleepy soul in his sleepy town found themselves awake and gathering around singing la la, la la love, la la, la la love.
And we are here at the Council for the Arts of Herndon, the Children's Art Center.
Well, my favorite part is actually the instruments, because they're noisy and they're colorful and they're pretty easy to make, so you can get something that shakes and is fun to play with. We're trying to give all the kids kind of a taste of what the different arts are. So we have different crafts here. There's painting, there's, you know, you can make your own jewelry, you can color. There's all kinds of fun stuff.
Today we are here at Jimmy's Old Town Tavern to have our third annual Play It Forward instrument donation drive. What we do is we ask people to go into their garages or their attics or under their beds and donate their used instruments to us. What the Council for the Arts does is we then refurbish them and we donate them back to local Herndon area schools.
We're here this evening to talk about the Council for the Art, a 13-year-old organization here in Herndon, and how they've kept the arts alive. Can you tell me a little bit about the mural that everyone's admiring? What is this about?
We have a mural project that we're working on. This will be going up, hopefully, on the side of Dominion Animal Hospital. Going to be quite a big project.
I think it really captures the history, and it really is neat.
Mike O'Reilly. I have the privilege of serving as the president for the Council for the Arts of Herndon.
Woo-hoo!
We are the sponsors and partnered with the veterinary clinic
in order to plan this mural.
The foundation and the Council for the Arts are doing to bring the arts alive in Herndon is just nothing short of amazing. It's a true volunteer effort. We are becoming known as a place in Fairfax County to come when you want to get involved in something fun or something with the arts.
One, two, three.
Woo! Cut!
The entire sixth grade class at Herndon Elementary is benefiting from Kwame Alexander's workshop. Their book of poetry will be designed, edited, and published with his guidance.
All right, we got our words. This is the next thing that I do when I'm writing a poem. I come up with all the words.
Really?
Yeah.
Special workshops are rarely funded. But Herndon Elementary Principal and Community Arts Council responded.
The Book in a Day program and all of our other after-school programs are really helping to move students to a more competent level, to increase their ability to think outside the box and be creative, and I think that's what the future needs.